Hi there, welcome to this session on services marketing with a practical approach. My name is Dr. Biplab Datta and my contact details are given here so that once you view the slides, once you see go through the session, you can send me any feedback that you have and I will be happy to respond to them. So this is lesson number 19, which is designing the service process part 1. So, we will look at developing the service blueprint. Now, you will appreciate that we should design the service process properly so that our company can deliver superior quality services to its customers. The plan for delivering the services called the service blueprint must be drawn so that all parties clearly understand how a service is to be delivered to its customers. While the service blueprint is a physical plan of the service process, we have to also understand the expectations of customers at various points during the process of service delivery. You will recall that our service would be considered to be of high quality only when it meets the expectations of our customers who purchase the service. A service blueprint gives an indication of the roles that employees, customers, and collaborators have to play so that customers can get the benefit of the service and its outcomes. These issues have been discussed in this lesson. In 1984, G. Lynn Shostak coined the term service blueprint to mean a visual diagram of the service process in terms of the step-by-step actions that the customer would be expected to follow in order to receive the service. The service blueprint of a restaurant is depicted in the figure later in this session. We can see that each customer action will take place at a physical location, which is part of the service scape. It is important that each part of the service scape gives the impression expected of the brand of the customer, as the customer would be observing these physical cues of the service. For instance, a creaky door at the entrance would signify an ill-maintained service outfit, and a soiled menu card would raise doubts in the minds of customers about the level of hygiene maintained at the restaurant. On the other hand, a light, refreshing music can help to provide some comfort to the tired and hungry customer while he is waiting for the food to be served at a sit-in restaurant. The customer would be interacting with service personnel, who are called on-stage contact, as these contact employees would be visible to the customer while interacting with them and performing the service. You may note that on-stage contact personnel interact with the customer at several points in the line of interaction. These points can be considered as pictorial representation of the moments of truth, a term coined by Jan Carlson in 1980. To signify the moments where service personnel interact and deliver a part of the service to the customer. At each of these points, contact personnel must fulfill the needs of the customer and satisfy him or her. If they are unable to meet the needs of the customer at this point, the customer will be dissatisfied. However, the customer will be delighted if contact personnel are able to figure out the latent needs of the customer at these points and deliver a part of the service that has not been expected by the customer. Just as customers would have interactions with service personnel, they would similarly interact with elements in the service scape knowingly or unknowingly. They must have a pleasant experience with these moments of truth too. That is why it is important to give enough attention to the design of the elements of the service scape, as these elements would in turn determine the quality of experience that customers have at a particular service scape. On-stage contact personnel would receive support from backstage contact personnel, who would not be visible to customers, yet they may serve the customer over phone, internet, etc. Hence, backstage contact personnel are separated from the customers by a virtual line of visibility. Service personnel may be further supported by various support processes, often driven by a customer. Often customers would interact with the front end of a support process like a computer touch screen for receiving information as part of their service. So, this is what I was talking to you about a service blueprint. Here you see the blueprint of a restaurant service. So, in this you see that the customer who is the king. So, what are the customer actions? He arrives at the restaurant, he is seated at the restaurant, he orders food, he waits for the food, he eats the food, he washes, he receives bill, he pays and he leaves. So, these are these 8 functions that the customer does, 8 actions that the customer does. Now, this customer will actually for each of these actions, the customer may be interacting with the on-stage contact person from the service supplier side. So, the service supplier would delegate somebody to greet the person who has arrived at the restaurant and indicate the table to him. Then he should give waiter water and menu to the person after he is seated. Then he takes the order while the customer orders the food. Having taken the order, he crosses the line of visibility and gives the order to the backstage contact personnel. Then the support processes takes the order from the backstage contact personnel and prepares the food. Then this food is delivered across the line of internal interaction and across the line of visibility, and the food is served. So, here we have talked about 3 lines. One is the line of interaction between the customer and the on-stage support person or on-stage contact person. Then we have the line of visibility beyond which nothing is visible to the customer. So, he gives the order and the backstage contact person takes the order and then crosses the line of internal interaction to the cook who prepares the food. Then you see he waits and then he eats the food which is served to him. Again, there is a contact between the on-stage contact person and the customer. Then the customer washes and he receives the bill by the contact person. The contact person in turn receives the bill by the prepare bill support process. Then he makes customer pays, and there is a transaction which is made with the help of the on-stage contact person, and the on-stage contact person thanks the customer when the customer leaves the restaurant premises. Now, when the customer arrives at the restaurant, he looks at the entrance door, then later on he sees the restaurant interior, then he sees the tabletop and menu, he sees the interior ambience, the food and cutlery while eating the food, the wash area while washing, the bill itself after he receives it, the currency which is returned to him once he pays, and the exit door at the time of leaving. So, we see that this is the line of visual interaction between the customer and the physical evidence. Okay, the parts of the environment. So, and then there is the line of interaction between the customer action and the on-stage contact person. Now, we see that this interaction between the customer and the contact person, at the line of interaction there is a cross. Okay. So, at this cross there is the black dot which is called the moments of truth. So, at this moment of truth where the customer interacts with the service personnel, at this moment of truth the service personnel have to satisfy or even delight the customer. So, there are several such moments of truth where the customer at different points in time interacts with the service personnel. And at every moment of truth, at the line of interaction, there is a black dot which indicates that this is the moment of truth. So, when the service provider serves the food and the customer eats the food, there is again a moment of truth. So, at these moments of truth, there is the interaction between the customer and the service provider, and these interactions have to be such that the customer is either satisfied or delighted by the manner in which the service provider provides the service to the customer. So, these moments of truth are extremely important at the line of interaction, because service is delivered as an interaction between the customer and the service provider. Next, we see the line of visual interaction. Here, the customer actually interacts with the elements in the physical evidence, and he looks at those elements which are there as part of the physical evidence, and also sometimes interacts with them. For example, when the customer goes for washing his or her hands and mouth, he interacts with the wash area. He sees the wash area. If he sees a clean wash area, he is impressed. But if he sees a dirty or filthy wash area, then he is dissatisfied about the wash area. So, again you see that there is a interaction between the line of visual interaction and the interaction between the service provider, between the customer and the element in the physical evidence. So, these points are also moments of truth, which are the points of interaction between the customer and the physical evidence. So, at each of these points of truth, at each of these moments of truth, the customer should be satisfied with the element of physical evidence that he is exposed to, or he might be delighted with the elements in the physical evidence with which he interacts. Then, of course, we have the line of visibility, beyond which the customer cannot see, but this line of visibility, at this line of visibility, the on stage contact person interacts with the backstage contact person. Now, when he is interacting, if the interaction is a happy interaction, a pleasant interaction, then the on stage contact person would also have a happy attitude, would have a pleasant attitude with which he can serve the customer at the line of interaction at the moment of truth. Then we have the line of internal interaction between the support processes and the backstage contact person. So, the support processes should also be very nice or well played out, so that the backstage contact person is happy about the support process. He asked the backstage support process to prepare the food, and he is happy to get the food from the support process, and then he happily serves the food to the customer, and finally satisfying the customer or delighting the customer at this moment of truth. So, using this blueprint, we can not only understand what kinds of steps the customer is going to take, what actions the customer is going to take, and we can also design the physical evidence with which the customer comes in contact, mostly visually, but sometimes he also comes in contact with the bill, with the currency, with the exit door, with the wash area. So, this should be done immaculately. That means, the physical evidence should be immaculate. Next, we see another example of a service blueprint at a coffee cafe. So, here again we understand that the customer is the most important person in the premises, and therefore, the customer comes, he parks the vehicle, he arrives at the restaurant, he sits, he reads menu, he waits and watches and things like that. Again, there is the line of interaction, and at every cross section between the line of interaction and the interaction between the customer action and the on stage contact, that is the moments of truth. So, again you see that here there are 8 moments of truth, whence the service provider has to interact and delight or satisfy the customer who has come. The customer again interacts with the physical evidence like the parking lot, the entrance door, the interior design, etcetera, etcetera, when he should be either satisfied or he should be surprised and delighted by the kind of physical evidence, by the kind of ambience, by the elements of the physical evidence which are there, and he should be happy about it. Then we also have the line of visibility. So, the customer cannot see anything beyond the line of visibility, and then there is the line of internal interaction, and there is the support processes with which the bills are generated, etcetera. So, this is a service blueprint of a coffee cafe, and using this service blueprint, the one understands what are important to the customer and what kind of interactions both with the on stage contact person and with the physical evidence should be there, so that the customer is satisfied and delighted. Similarly, we have a service blueprint for blood collection service from the patient's residence. Again, the customer is the person who would provide blood for some kind of diagnosis. So, he telephones the diagnostic center, he receives sample collector, he gives blood sample, he asks the report, collection date and time, and he makes the payment. And there is the physical evidence, which is the customer's residence in this case, and also the appearance of the on-stage contact, and these points of interactions are also important. Then there is the on-stage contact person who receives the call and notes the time and address. He takes the blood sample, he gives details about the collection date and time, and he receives the payment and gives the receipt about the payment. And there is the line of visibility beyond which the customer cannot see, and that is the backstage contact person who sends message to the sample collector. And then there is the internal line of internal interaction, and there are several support processes like particularly computers which are helping the on stage contact person to serve the customer as well as possible. So, these are the examples of the service blueprint, which is not only used for in the marketing arena, but this can be also used for understanding the operations and to establish the operations of a particular facility like a restaurant or a patient's residence, etcetera. Once the blueprint of the service is ready, the service has to be developed further in terms of designing the moments of truth. For this, we would need to know the expectations of customers at each moment of truth. Moreover, the roles of various actors in the service delivery, including the service provider and the consumer, can be written out in detail in the form of a service script, which employees and others must learn in order to be able to properly deliver the service to customers. This aspect has been discussed in the next lesson. Thank you for watching. I hope it helps.